morning children. I am your English teacher. I hope you are all safe and fine. In previous classes, we have learned part 1 and part 2. The same story, supplementary story, Think to Win. Today, we are going to learn part 3. So this is for this last session in this story. Before going to the class, we can recap in part 1 and part 2, supplementary Think to Win. Okay, children? Yes. This lesson is based on positive attitude. You have to believe yourself and work towards achieving your goal. You should not think of losing, but think to win. Only to win. And then you can do it easily. Richard seldom did things rashly, even in running and playing. So one character name is Richard. She would be conscious of her movements. So who is a sister of Richard's? Seema. Seema, her younger sister, on the other hand, was bold and prone to taking risk, even while learning to ride a bicycle. She feared that she may fall off, little knowing that she was riding well. Her fear and hesitation made her fall off the bicycle. She was also upset when she lost the game inter-house badminton match by a couple of points. Her friends consoled her. Who is her friend? Aruna. And asked her to practice more for the relay in the inter-school sports meet. Richa feared that she would make everyone lose the race. As her friends compelled her to take up the race, she agreed and started practicing under the new PT instructor, Mr. Prakash sir. He was very enthusiastic about sports and drove the children, hard praising, scolding, correcting, but mostly encouraging them. Mr. Prakash sir overheard the conversation of the children that Springfield schools had a very fast runner, and they called her PT Usha, who is Shabnam. She took a quick decision to make the girls practice more on the field. He also motivated them, saying that their aim should be to win the race, not just to make an attempt in the relay. He showed them some exercises and that would allow their legs to stretch more and stride faster. He also trained them in the skill of passing the baton. Baton means which is using small stick, which is using in the relay, without losing their speed. So till that, we have learned in this story. Let's start part 3 in the same story. This is the final part of this story. Okay, children? Yes. So you can see 4 lines. In the last 4 lines, the next few days, he saw the girls training extra hard. Prakash sir was never far, even as he trained other children. So after some time, he saw the girls trained more. Prakash sir always watching them, even though he trained other children. The day of the sports meet dawned, and the children piled into buses to reach the venue. There was laughter and a great deal of joviality, as Prakash sir had seen to it that they were fit and relaxed as well. So in the sports meeting, the day has started. Children are gathered over there and reached the venue. Schoolgirls and the rich are enjoying, and they're fit and relaxed as well for the sports. The stadium where the meet was being held bustled with great activity. Children from several schools were moving around and checking out the children venues where particular events were to be held. Students are ready to start the program, and students were bustled with great activity. They were moving energetic to over there, and so many schools are participating in sports meet. So they are checking out the different venues where particular events were to be held. And then Prakash sir collected the schedule and gave the girls appropriate instructions. So Prakash sir collected the sports meet schedule and gave the proper instructions for the girl. The principal sir of the host of school inaugurated to meet with a short speech and also introduced to participating schools. Then the event started. So the principal of the school started the meet and with a short speech and also introduced the participating schools. Then the event started. Richard, most of the other children of that school easily got through the heats to enter the final scheduled for the following day. So Richard and other school students easily reached them final schedules for the following day. The next morning, after a few individual events, it was the time for the girls' relay race. 4 schools had entered into the finals. Richa, Aruna, Shabnam and Neelam were Team B. So in the next morning, for knowing events, was the time for the girls' relay race. There are so many schools that participated in the sports meet, but finally 4 schools had entered in the sports relay. Richa, Aruna, Shabnam and Neelam were Team B. Prakash sir gave them final words of encouragement. Girls, you are a good team. You can win. Go ahead and show your mettle. Good luck. So Prakash sir gave them final words encouragement. This is a very important line. Girls, you are a good team. You can win. Go ahead and show your mettle. Good luck. The next paragraph. Shabnam, a tall girl, was their first runner. She would pass the baton to Neelam. Neelam would pass it to Aruna and Aruna to Richa, who would finishing the race for them. So Shabnam, she is the first runner in the team. She would pass to the baton to Neelam. Neelam would pass to Aruna and Aruna to Richa. So Richa is the last runner. She is finishing the race for them. The whistle blew and first runner were off with a long stride, and Shabnam gave the team a marginal lead. So the whistle blew, the race started. Shabnam gave the team a marginal lead. By the time Neelam had passed the baton to Aruna, both Team A and D had drawn level with her. So Neelam had passed the baton to Aruna, both a team and D also equal level with her. Then the runner of the Team D fumbled and dropped the baton. Aruna ran fall. All she was fourth, just managing to keep abreast of the runner of Team A. So the runner of the Team D has dropped the baton. Aruna was fourth. She ran safely and passed the baton to them other person. So in the next paragraph, finally the baton was in Richa's hand. Finally, the baton was in Richa's hand. She had already noted with dismay that she was pitted against P.T. Usha of Team A. So finally, the baton is a place in Richa's hand. She would already noted with dismay that she was pitted against P.T. Usha of Team A. The tough runner P.T. Usha now is equal to Richa. Just my luck, she thought, and had flashed through her mind. She had quickly put the thought aside when the baton was passed to her. Just my luck, that word is appeared in her mind. But she had quickly put the thought aside, the baton was passed to her. She was more than ready. She heard the shouts of her schoolmates, Richa, come on, Richa, Richa. Out of the corner of her eye, Richa saw P.T. Usha trying to overtake her. So she saw P.T. Usha trying to overtake her, then quickly reached in her mind P.T. Prakash's words, and then she heard the shouts of her schoolmates, Richa, come on, Richa, Richa, out of the corner of the eye. Then fleetingly she thought, not again. Then Prakash's words came to her, think to win. The next moment Richa was conscious of nothing except the tape of at finishing the line, which had to reach. So there is nothing in her mind, Prakash's words appearing in her mind. This is only thing to win. Richa, she is very conscious to finishing the line which she had to reach. Totally observed, she ran, she lost that time and distance. Finally, she ran on, not conscious of the fact that the race was over, till Aruna called out to her, Richa, you have won, we have won. And she was hugging and kissing her. Prakash sir was beaming at her and everyone was applauding her. Even P.T. Usha came over to shake her hand. So finally she ran, There is nothing in her mind. She wants to win the race. Finally, she heard the words from Arunas, "Richa, you have won. We have won." And she was hugging and kissing her. Prakash sir seeing happily at her, and everyone was applauding her. Even P.T. Usha came over to shake her hand. "I thought I was fast, but you were simply superb." She shook her hands with her. Finally, the opponent from Team A, P.T. Usha, said to Richa, "I thought I was fast, but you are simply superb." She shook her hands with her. It is always a proud moment for a winner of a medal when she is called to the victory stand. But for Richa, she had a double meaning. She had overcome with her hesitations and denials. She could win whenever she chose to. So now it's a proud moment. She had overcome with her hesitations and denials. Finally, she won the match. So children, moral of the story is, we must have self-confidence and boldness and interest. So, okay children, you can enjoy this video. So this story is written Lata Kaku. So enjoy learning, and you have to go through this video again and again, then only you can understand the story. Okay children, I hope you all understood this story. So moral of this story, we have boldness and interest and self-confident, then only we can achieve in anything. Okay children, thank you.